Hello, beautiful souls.
Yep.
Okay, so I clearly don't have a bunch of breath voice to spare, so I'm going to get right into it. If you're catching the replay, put hashtag replay. Dang, you know, the enemy will try to take your voice when you have a message. So, sales is really interesting because, whenever we do stuff like this, we're touring different apartments and places. Whenever we do this, it instantly makes me think about when I used to sell glasses. And I really had to learn, first of all, self-confidence is everything. And self-confidence is everything in sales. You can't sell anything to me if you're not confident in yourself. Especially depending on what you're selling. So we toured 3 apartments today. And literally each one was a different experience. The first one, the self-confidence was not there at all from the leasing perspective. You know, you have to stand firm in your authority. In life, period, not even just sales. And it was just such a trip to me. I was just telling my hubby, it's cringy. It was such a trip to me that, you know, before you tour an apartment, you have to give them your ID. And the lady was like, we asked, like, do you need both of our ID? And instead of just saying, yes, please, or yes, I'll need both, very straightforward, she says, well, one ID is okay. Hi, Ashley. She's like, oh, well, I can just take one. I don't need both. What is your policy? Do you need both of our IDs or not? Be firm. You can't sell me. I'm easily sold. I put all my eggs in one basket. So if it makes sense to me, if it looks good, if we're talking good, then I'm sold. Which is why the second place we went to, I was totally sold. The way you speak to me, the way you communicate is everything. You come to me bossed up. Hi, welcome. You know, can I get you guys some coffee? What else, babe? She was just so, when she took us on a tour, she was like, so when you arrive to your home, this is where you'll be coming in. It was just really bossed up, a different posture.
She was even bossed up from a straightforward perspective. Like when she asked us, how do we hear about the property, we didn't give a straight answer.
And she got her answer.
And she got her answer, exactly.
You know, I'll tell you exactly how that went. We heard about this place from a referral. But you told her, like, oh, you know, we were just driving by because it's a local place. And because we didn't give her a clear answer, as a salesperson who needs to collect all of the necessary information, she didn't drill us. Drill it. Sales is, like, really a skill. She didn't drill it out of us immediately. She circled back around in such a classy little way. It was just like, so, I'm just going to say that you heard about us from referral, huh? Damn, I'm going to have to get off of here. Enemy will really try to take your voice. With all that being said, let me wet my whistle. And hurry up before summer starts fussing. So it makes me think about several years ago when I used to sell eyeglasses. And glasses, I'm not sure if you guys have purchased glasses, they can really add up. And I was selling people thousands of dollars worth of eyeglasses. I mean, they could come in and they would need a pair of bifocal progressives, transitions when they turn dark outside. You know, part of the whole sales technique with optics, just gotta be honest, you guys. You guys probably get bamboozled with this all the time. Always, you know, press to sell the second pair. Don't get me wrong, this isn't like an optical lesson, but everybody should have a backup pair of glasses. But that's why it's so easy to sell it. You need a second pair of glasses. You need a pair of polarized sunglasses. You know, it's also important to build relationships. This wasn't even supposed to be a training, but we know this. We know this stuff. We've been doing this stuff for so long. You know, you can't sell something to somebody that you know nothing about them. You have to build some type of relationship. Even now, building a relationship doesn't necessarily mean I took 10 years to get to know you. It doesn't have to take that long. Building relationships can be the brief bit of information that these leasing consultants got from us. They know that we're a young married couple. They know that we're self-employed. They know we have a toddler. You know, they know that we're in from this area. They know that we travel often, you know. So now I can sell to you because I warmed it up a little bit. So, for example, with eyeglasses, there actually was a whole procedure. And that's what I love about, like, business management. I would never want to do a brick-and-mortar business ever again. But I learned so much that you can apply to your online business. It's so crazy. So, it was like a 5 questions that you asked. Like, what do you do for a living? Like, what do you do during the day? What do you do in your leisure time? You know, what are your, some of your extracurricular activities? And that's important because you can go back and say, well, based on what you told me, you need a pair of polarized sunglasses because you always travel. You're always on the beach. What is it? I'll see you on the banks or the beaches. You told me you're always on the beach. So you absolutely need a pair of polarized sunglasses. And you told me you have a toddler. Toddlers break glasses. I don't know if you're new to this. Toddlers break glasses. So you need a second pair. And it's simple. And I say this all to say, you know, I can be this transparent because I know that I have customers on here. And just understand that I definitely have a rapport with my customers. They don't just buy from me and go about their business. I got a text message earlier that said, hey girl, I lost 5 pounds in 5 days and showed me that scale. And she was like, we got this, sis. Like, I'm getting started on Friday. And it's a real genuine relationship built because we relate to each other. She has a toddler, you know? And I'm saying that I can be transparent with the sales portion because I encourage anyone that is teachable and coachable, has a positive mindset, and basically meets the requirements to become one of my CBD partners, I encourage you to do so, especially because if you're already a customer, all you have to do is upgrade your package and add $50, and then you get paid for it. So I don't have to be transparent about my sales technique or what I know about sales because I encourage you to get started and I teach you everything that I know. So last thing, it just really, being in these types of situations, you really have to know how to close the deal because your self-confidence will allow you to not close the deal on somebody that's already sold. I mean, seriously.
Like, and you'll unsell them.
Exactly. And then I've just learned so much in my work career because I was just looking at how this lady forgot half of the information that would have sold us to move there like this. They have a shuttle to the airport.
Unlimited shuttle access. And discounts to all the restaurants.
We're business.
Around the complete duration of the apartment.
Discounts on the hotel that they own. All of this is like an easy sell for us. We always have people, business partners coming in town that need a place to stay. So that would have sold us off jump. But yeah, it's just really a trip because we could have already been sold on this particular apartment. But she didn't know how to close the deal in like a really, really solid way.
Right, it was like this.
A lot of like rambling. Yeah. So I just wanted to like drop that really quick. Hopefully you guys got some value. Sales is really everything. Self-confidence is everything. And not even just in sales. You really have to carry yourself. Even if you have to carry yourself in the way where you want to be. You can't carry yourself for what your bank account says right now. And what your current situation is looking at like right now. You're never going to drive a Rolls Royce if you don't, like, boss up and ride in whatever car you're driving in right now. You're never going to be able to have, like, the super fly wardrobe if you don't, like, boss up and have self-confidence in what you have right now. You have to have the self-confidence. Put your shoulders back. Lift your head up. Fake it.
Put your shoulders back.
Like, it's so disheartening to see people that lack self-confidence because it, you know, it just comes so easy to me. But it takes a lot of growth. And I see a lot of people that just don't have the self-confidence. You can see how they look, how they carry themselves, how they put themselves together. I don't care if you have $0 in your bank account. Put your shoulders back, put your chin up, and walk like you're a boss.
Because you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Yeah, like, you real life deserve it.
Don't ever let anybody limit you or make you feel like you are not that. Because, girl, you are that. Bro, you are that. And if there's anybody in your circle, anybody in your family, anybody in your friends that make you feel like you are not what you know that you are, they gotta go, boo. So, that's all.